So in the series of learning programming in C, in the previous video, I have discussed about if statement, right? Everything about if statement, every single detail with the help of a flowchart and program, what tricky type of questions can be asked using that if statement. That also we have discussed what kind of error you can do while writing if statement in your program, right? Everything we have discussed. Now in this video, I'll be discussing about if else statements with the help of a flowchart also, the working of if else statement, general syntax of writing if else statement, as well as with the help of a program we are going to discuss. We'll see when you use if else statement in your program, what output you will get, what kind of tricky questions can be formed using if else statements, what kind of error you can do while writing if else statement in your program. Everything we'll be discussing about if else statement in this video. So now let us discuss about if else statement in C. It is what you can say extension of simple if statement. There we write simple if statement. If the condition is true, only that time, the if statement would be executed. Otherwise, it's okay. There would be no action, or the statements which are written after the if block means that are not part of that if block, that would be executed, right? But here, if else, what you can do here, there would be two blocks. In the if statement, we are having only one block, that is that true block. Here, we are having two blocks. If the condition is true, one block would be executed, maybe some set of statements would be executed. Else, if the condition is not true, then also you can provide some statements that these statements would be executed, means these statements should be executed if the condition is not true. And after that, statements which are not a part of if else block, you can write down those statements also, those would be executed. You can get it better with that real life example. If you are going to a supermarket, then you are asked to, if you are asked to buy what? If oranges are available, buy oranges. Otherwise, buy quinoas or buy mosambis. Otherwise, in real life, we say what? Otherwise, in the terms of this program, when we write program, then we say what? Else, rather than otherwise, right? And if you use simple if, then like if oranges are available, buy oranges. There is no otherwise. And come to your home. If not available, it's fine. Come to your home, right? So now here, we have two blocks mainly, if block and else block, means true block and false block. What is the general syntax of writing this if else statement? We write if, here we write some condition or the test expression you can say. And here we have what? The true block statements. Else, simply you will write here false block statements. And after that also you can write down some statements. That would be what? After if else block statement. Those are not part of that if else. See, same funda is here. I'm writing these curly braces because here I'm writing true block statements, more than one statement. If there is only one statement, no need to write these curly braces. Same in else, if one statement, no need to write down these curly braces. If you are writing multiple statements, means blocks, false block statements, then multiple statements, more than one statement, then you need to write down these curly braces. If you are writing multiple statements and you are not writing curly braces, what problem you are facing, that we have discussed in the previous video also. That also we'll discuss, here also we'll discuss that thing with the help of that program. Now, if you use a flowchart, then how you can show the working of this if else using flowchart? See, simple, the execution of the program is here, sequential flow, but after that we are finding if else block, means some condition is there. Right, and this condition, if the condition is true, then this true block statements would be executed, right? If the condition is false, at that time false means the control will go to else, means false block statement would be executed. And after that, finally, both the cases, after this also, these statements would be executed. The after if else block statement. So here you can write after if else block statements, right? That would be executed. So this is what that flow chart of this thing, the working of the if else statement, right? I hope you got the flow chart. So let us take the same example, but here I'm writing two blocks, if and else. Same, I'm entering the age, right? If age is greater than 25 and age is less than 30. I am writing here two conditions, right? So if this condition is true, true means here 0 means false, 1 means true, right? True here means 1, then this block would be executed. Here I am writing curly braces because I am writing two statements. Age, it would print age and coffee with me. Else, if the condition is not true, then what should be printed on the screen? That we can also give using if else, right? But we cannot do the otherwise, the false, or the these kind of actions when we are using simple if statement. So if this condition is not true, if age is not between 25 to 30, then what should be printed? Age would be printed, and what message should be printed? Go home, right? And after if else block, I'm just printing one more statement out of if block. Now what output you will get? Suppose this is your output screen. What it will ask? First of all, enter age, and I'm entering age, suppose 28, right? Then it will take the condition, age greater than 25, greater than 25. Yes, it is true, but it is logical and so it will check the second condition also, because both one, then only it will give one, that we have discussed when we are discussing the logical operators. Age less than 30, it is less than 30, yes, both are true, it means the condition is true, means one means the control will go within this if block. The first statement in if block is age equal to, it will print age, that is 25 in, and after this in the same line it will print coffee with me, or if you use slash and then it will print next line coffee with me, right? Now that's it, it will not execute the else block because the condition is true, right? After that, directly after this statement, control will go here. After this false block statement, the control will directly go here after if else block statement. So those are here out of if else, so that would also be printed out of if else, right? And suppose I'm entering age is equal to 20. Now see, age greater than 25, but condition is not true, that is false. So if first expression is false, then in logical and it will not check the second, because finally it will give false. False means it will not go in within this if block, directly control will go within this else block, right? So in this case, what would be printed? Age is equal to 20, and printf here, what would be printed? Go home. After the false, again, which statement would be printed? This out of if else, that would also be printed. See, this is not a part of if else block. It is part of the program. So definitely it is going to be executed if the condition is false or true, it doesn't matter, right? So now here, if suppose you are writing semicolon here, in the if statement, if you write semicolon here, then it's okay. You are terminating the if statement and the if block would be executed, and these statement would be also be executed after the if block. But here, if you write semicolon here, that generally students do these kind of mistakes, then you will get an error message. What? Misplaced else. In Turbo C, or if you are using that Visual Studio, maybe you are getting that else without previous if. In this case, it will give error message because you are terminating if, right? There is no use of this if now, but here you are using else. So without if, you cannot write else. Remember this thing, without if, you cannot write else, but without else, you can write if. It is not necessary to write down else. We can also write down simple if statements that we have discussed in previous video, right? So now you cannot write down semicolon here, it will give you an error message. And here one more thing, if you not write these curly braces, right, then also it will give error message. Why? Because by default, what, the first line, only the first line after this if would be considered as a part of this if block, right? So this line would be considered as a part of this if block, and this is what, out of if block, when this is part of that program. And after this line you cannot write else, because else you can write directly after the if block. So means by default this is if block, so after this you can write down else, but you have written one more line, printf, that is part of program, not part of this if. So here it will give error, misplaced else. Here also it will give error, right? But if you are writing, suppose I'm commenting this, if I'm writing is only single line, that is fine. No need to write down curly braces. Else, you can write down curly braces. Or here also, if you not write down curly braces, then also it will work fine. Here, if suppose this is the case, I'm not writing this line. This is, I'm commenting this line. I'm not writing curly braces here. And if suppose you are entering age here, 28, the condition is true. It will enter here. It will print age, that is 28. Write down, fine. And after that, see now else part. Now these two statements are not part of this else block. Why so? Because by default only one statement it will consider as a part of this else. You are not writing curly braces. So now this statement would be considered as a part of the program, not if else block. So now this statement would also be executed, like go home would be printed, and out of if block, if else block would be also be printed, right? So you need to take care of this thing. And suppose I'm writing these two lines here, so you need to put there curly braces, and you can remove curly braces from here. That is fine. It will not give, now it will not give error, right? But it will consider only the first line as a part of if. These two line would be part of after if else block statement, and these two line would be executed no matter condition is true or false, right? So now I hope you got the idea about if else block. So now this is assignment for you. This is the program, right? If the same the condition, I'm writing these curly braces here. Else, I'm not writing any curly braces here, right? And when you run the program, then you have to tell me what output you will get. If you enter age, one is 25 and second age is 32. In both the cases, what output you will get, you have to tell me in comment box, right? So now I hope you got the idea of if else statements also. Or you can write down your own program, like suppose you are going to enter a number and you have to tell the number is positive or negative, or the number is even or odd, or the number is prime or not prime. So these kind of program you can do, because now you have the idea about if statement and if else statements. So now I'll see you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye bye.